We were talking about work sampling, right? There are mostly we have done the chapter, but just a second. So what are the advantages of work sampling? In the last class, we have seen that we do work sampling by finding out what are the number of the samples. Then subsequently, we find out how many observations are to be taken, at what time the observations are to be taken. And then we classify the activities in various forms. And then we note those activities happening every time when we take the observation. So what are the advantages of work sampling? The very obvious advantage is that it will take less time if we take direct observation or we do 100% sampling. So it's definitely going to take less time than that. It's going to be less costly. Other than that, we can say less time consuming. Less cost. And the training requirements, if we compare it with the method study, in the method study, we need to do predetermined motion time study, or the training requirements are less.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah?
Sir, aapki presentation visible nahi hai. Well, it's just showing presentation by Gunjan Soni, but nothing is visible.
Okay, I'll just come back to that. I will share it again.
How it's visible?
Yeah, so training cost is less. These are some of the advantages. Less tiresome and monotonous, because the observer has to less tiresome. And monotonous. Less tiresome and monotonous because the observations are to be taken at intervals and not continuously. Some of the limitations of the work study could be if we talk about limitations or disadvantages, it's not as accurate for setting time standards as other work like time study. So less accurate. And it's generally not practical to study a single subject because you have to consider workers as a whole also. So although when you are doing work sampling, you are concentrating more on a single subject. At different intervals, you are either watching a machine or a worker working. So if you have to make a larger conclusion about the system, it may not be very practical. So you can say less practical.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, but while doing method study, we only our view is only on a particular subject. Then how is that practical? So,
actually, method study, we are trying to come up with standard operating procedure. While in work study, the objective, if you look at it, the objective of both are different. Method study objective is to generally come up with the standard operating procedures or which are optimal. While work sampling aims to find out non-value added activities more, right? So although it can supplement method study, But then in generalization is more in method study as compared to that in the work sampling. So that's why we are saying it is less practical, because we are trying to generalize something, some observations about the system with numbers and all. Right? I'm clear. Yes, then, since we are trying to generalize in work sampling, many individual problems, or you can say some special problems which exist with certain individuals or machines, might get missed out. Okay, and this is about mostly about the work sampling. This was about chapter 19. Now, chapter 20 is. Very small chapter, and about time measure. I mean, the time, the equipments which I use to monitor and record the times. So most of them are archaic, purana ho chuka hai. So I'll just send you the slides. I'm coming to chapter 21 now. Which is time study. Now, the main things which we will discuss in this chapter would be how do we select a job for doing time study? What should be the approach of the work study personnel towards the worker? What are the steps? And how do we break job into elements, which is a very important part of it. By the way, by looking at the video, have you people been able to split into elements? Let's see, let's discuss something, that how do we split them into elements, or what do I mean by splitting into elements? I'm again going to show the video to you, and we will talk about it in brief. I'm just sharing from another screen.
Our normal videos today, we're going to be swapping over the shop from our one-off custom type shop to production mode. We've got two jobs coming up back to back that are just knock them out as fast as we can. We got deadlines to hit, so we're going to go through how we do it. Let's go. Effectively just pallet racking, except the different size, different application, different width than normal pallet. To thinking that some people might get something from it. Tommy has already cut up a lot of the material for this job and added together. Okay, so I know this doesn't look like much. Legs he can cut.
He's anyway going to tell you the steps. So let me just clarify that part.
Flanges to bolt pieces together to the legs he cut. So we're gonna jump right into putting the jig together. Okay, so I know this doesn't look like much, but what we're doing is setting a jig up to make these L-shaped pieces. This first piece.
So he says setting the jig up is the first thing. Okay, so setting up the
this
jig.
Gets dropped in. Just pull it tight up against these guys.
So holding up tight against the stoppers is part of setting up the jig.
Second piece dropped into place right here. Push flush up against.
Yeah, you guys, you can see that a jig here is totally worth it. We had a jig to put
some of the activities he is going to repeat, some of the activities you have to observe, and then you have to write it down. So when we are doing time study, we have to break it down into elements. There are rules for breaking down into the elements. So you listen to them carefully while keeping in mind that this video is what you are going to apply this splitting of elements to. In the, probably you can't, it's not in the, he's not doing it in the real time, it is slightly fast forwarded, so you probably can't note the time, but let's see if we can do that. But the whole activity
on the legs, we had another jig to put the flanges on the ends of these eight.
One observation could be taken, one or two observations.
Those flanges are just plasma cut 10 gauge going onto this inch and a half square tube. It's pretty
right
easy.
Now. It's not happening in the real time. I mean, it's happening in the real time. It's not
possible. You can see on this end piece that we just cut a square into the flange with a little dog bone on the corners so that the square tube would slide right into the flange, square it all up, you're good to go. The jig probably takes 20-30 minutes to build and get right, get all the pieces tacked down nice and square, but this run that you're seeing here on the screen uninterrupted took 1 minute 58 seconds start to finish to make one of these assemblies. We have to make
it's also in the total time he's taking. So I think when we are going to talk about this time study, I'll tell you what things are expected from your side while you are watching this video. Okay, so coming back to what we were discussing.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, in chapter 19 in the book, there were topics like group sampling techniques, structured and comparative estimating, and conducting the study. Have we had any discussion regarding those topics, or those topics aren't to be covered by us?
Well, if we go too much into detail, we can discuss it, but then I see that the essence of the work sampling already covered, right? So if you have any doubts regarding that, you can ask me. For course sake, I will say that we are not covering that.
Okay, sir.
In the course. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So when we are doing the time study, we can talk about the first thing that we should be talking about is how do we select the job. So first step is selecting the job. Under what conditions a job is eligible to be time studied? So we can say that if it's a new job which is coming, a new job, like let's say operation was done earlier manually, now that operation will be done with machine, or an human operator will be there who will be operating the machine, so it will be automatic. So this is a new job which has come, although the output would be the same or similar, but the job profile has changed now. So we can see that when you are having a new product or a new component which is being made, which was not time studied earlier, or a new operation or new set of activities, then we can go for a time study in that case. Or there has been a change in the material, or the because of the method study, we found out that it has to be done in a different way. So a different method has evolved, or a new time standard is required. So then in that case, we can do the time study. Or certain complaints have been received from the representative about the time standard of the operation, that your time standard is too tight, and a certain job you are expecting us to do in 10 minutes is a standard time, and if you don't do it in 10 minutes, then the rewards will not be there. So they want the time to be extended. So that could be one of the reasons. Or if there are bottlenecks in the system and we want to study the bottlenecks, that time we do the time study. If we have to associate incentives like extra pay for doing the time, doing the job before time or in standard time. So standard time, we'll talk about it. Standard time is something which you expect from a normal worker to do in normal conditions. So if you are able to do that in standard times, then there are some incentives associated with it. So you have to establish standard time, then in that case we need to do time study. So these are some of the reasons which promotes the use of time study. While if the purpose of the study is setting up of performance standards, generally it is advised to normally be undertaken under method study. I mean, method study already should have been done. So if my objective is to set up performance standards, so before setting up performance standards, the same job should be studied with method. First, the method has to be studied, like method study has to be carried out first. And once it has been standardized by applying standard operating procedures, then we go for time study. So this is one precaution that you have to, you just can't jump onto a time study until unless you have established the standard operating procedures. So the assignment which you are doing, the method study assignment, after 20 seconds, it will be extended to time study. So while you are doing the taking the readings, you may also visit the time study. So the replication part or if you, may be avoided. Or if it's a domestic work, then of course it's easier for you to take the readings again. So generally, time study supplements method study and takes it further. So after 20 seconds, I'll give you some more time. By 30th, you'll have to submit the time study part of the same assignment which you are doing. So what should be the approach of selecting a worker whom you're going to make a specimen for time study? Because let's say 100 workers are there. You can't do a time study of 100 workers. But you need to select one worker who is standard worker, or who is a competent worker, or a qualified worker. So how do we define that? So we can say a qualified worker is the one who has acquired the skill of doing the job, who has the knowledge and other attributes to carry out the work in hand satisfactorily with respect to quantity, quality and safety. Okay, so generally, it's easier for a shop floor supervisor to select a person who can be used as a specimen for establishing the time standards. Okay, isko hum standard maan sakte hain, iska kaam acha hai. So maybe some data is required, maybe you can gather some information about the workers, or you can observe the workers for 4-5 days and find out who is turning out to be a good worker, and you can set him as a specimen. So it's not, it's the worker should not be like extraordinary. The representative worker should be the one whose skill and performance is average of the group, and not necessarily a very qualified worker, you can say. But like we cannot expect the stars of the group and set them as standards, because it's not humanly possible for every person to become like the best. For example, in a class, if I give that you should become like, everyone should become like the person who is getting the maximum CGPA in the class. So that is something unfair to many people, because every human being has different quality and then their competency is different. Very good at something, but maybe average at something else. So that's why Average qualified worker is the one who has acquired the skill, knowledge, and other attributes to carry out the work in hand, and should have satisfactory standards with respect to quantity, quality, and safety. So what do we say is a standard performance? So now we talked about average qualified worker. Who is average qualified worker? So generally, quantity, quality, and safety. These are the three main important things. If he is following these three things religiously, so we can select and consider him to be an average worker. So standard performance. Why do we want to select a qualified worker? We want to set up a standard for time of doing the job. You must be confused that what was work sampling and what is time study, under what paradigm it falls in. Matlab ke shuru mein humne padha tha method study, work study hai, work study ke andar method study aata hai. And what is the second thing? Yes, anyone?
Work measurement,
right? So we are finding out, we are talking about various things about work measurement. So one of the thing which we study about work measurement was work sampling. The second one we are talking about is time study. Okay, so you should the classification should be clear in your mind. So standard performance. So in order to establish the time standards, we have to establish standard performance. So standard performance is pace of working that can be maintained by a representative worker, that is the average qualified worker, throughout entire work shift without stressing out or without getting fatigued. I mean, the harmful effects on worker's health and physical being should not be there. So with that pace, what is the work we can expect? What, how much amount of work we can expect when the conditions are humanly conducive? So we have another term which is normal performance. So there is a difference between normal and standard. We will talk about that. So normal performance, we can say, although they are the same things, but we will see that later. So normal performance is the 100% pace with which a worker works. While standard performance, we can say, is again the 100% pace with, 100% performance with which average worker is going to work. But in this, we consider periodic breaks or contingencies, like going to washroom, taking small breaks in between, forgetting the concentration back. All those things are considered in the standard. So you can say normal performance plus allowances make up the standard time. You can say normal time plus allowances in terms of time will make up the standard time. Okay. there have been like some benchmarks already been established by ILO, like walking of the worker on a shop floor is generally considered average worker is going to walk 3 miles per hour or 5 kilometers per hour on a level flat ground. So these things have already been, many standards already exist for a worker in a factory. So what are the steps when, yeah, anything? So what are the steps in making a time study? So the main steps is, first step would be select a job. Second would be to define. the define means define the elements, break the job into elements convenient for timing, obtain and record. Obtain and record the data relating to the method, operator, job, and the working conditions. Then extend time duration of each element and access the rating. So once you have taken the observation, then time duration for each element is taken down, and we do the rating of it. Then computation of the standard time, compute standard time for the operation of for the defined job, and then I think please mute your mics, some kind of disturbance is there, and determine. So determine the relaxation and personal allowances. So these are some steps which we are going to follow in the time study.
Sir, selecting means only selecting the work or the person on which we are going to do time study.
Job. Selecting the job or the work.
Okay, sir. One more doubt. Why we are taking the normal person? Isn't it demotivating the highly skilled worker to do less?
नहीं, there will be incentives associated ना, जो ज़्यादा करेगा उसके लिए अच्छा ही है, उसको एवरेज थोड़ी बनाना है. देखिए इस तरीके, अगर आप लेट्स से हमने स्टैंडर्ड, हमने आपको टाइम दिया कि 8 आवर शिफ्ट में 10 वर्क पीसेस बनाने हैं, अगर आप 10 से ज्यादा बनाते हैं तो आपको इंसेंटिव मिलेगा. ओके, सो स्टैंडर्ड एस्टेब्लिश किया है कि आपको 10 वर्क पीसेस बनाने हैं 8 आवर वर्कशीट में.
सर देन व्हाट्स द बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस, इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग की जो सबसे अच्छा कर रहा है उसको हम स्टैंडर्ड मान ले और बाकी सबको उसके कंपैरिजन में पे मिले.
तो फिर नहीं सकते ना.
आपको बोला जाए कि क्लास में जो टॉपर है, कि आप जो हर बच्चे को बिल्कुल टॉपर जैसा ही नंबर लाके लेके आ रहे हैं, तो ऐसा अच्छा ही बात है क्या?
नो सर, बट द पे विल बी लाइक जो सबसे हाईएस्ट है उसके अकॉर्डिंग हम पे सेट कर देंगे और रिमेनिंग्स विल गेट अकॉर्डिंगली.
लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर उसमें, आपको देयर कुड बी फिजिकल is physical problems with the people also. Everyone cannot match that standard. People will strive for it. Karenge log, definitely try karenge.
Aur sir, abhi bhi to aisa hi hai. Jo sir zyada kar raha hai usko aise bhi incentives aur baaki sab to mil hi raha na. To ek tarike se zyada payment.
Dekho, I would not say on record, like we can consider there are some places jo follow nahi karti hai standards. Uske liye hum kuch nahi keh sakte. But there are in Western world, they follow these norms very very religiously, most of the places in Western world. Jo industrial laws hain, jahan pe labor laws bahut strong hain, where a person, ek kisi labor ko maan lijiye chot lag jati hai, so he can go to the court and sue the company. Yahan pe aisa nahi hai. So I mean, if a labor goes in depression because of working heavily, because the standards itne set up kiye hue hain, so you can actually go to court if the labor laws are strong. Getting it? So it all is about human rights, you can say, or something like that. Kiska question tha vaise?
Okay sir.
Vineet yes, ya Ram?
Sir, my Vineet.
Okay, so I hope you don't open a factory yaar. बहुत काम करवाओगे नहीं तो तुम. ठीक है,
so I am planning to do so.
हाँ, तो फिर ये समझ लो के consider human beings as human beings and not machines.
Sir, my idea was just कि हमें दो चीजों का ध्यान ना रखना पड़े. अगर हम normal average को ले तो हमें जो average से below है उनके लिए और जो average से up है, उन दो अलग अलग चीजों का ध्यान रखने की बजाय हम हमारे पास जो रहेंगे सब एवरेज से सब बिलो ही रहेंगे अगर हम हाईएस्ट को स्टैंडर्ड माने और उनके अकॉर्डिंगली उनको पे करें. या बट द ह्यूमन राइट्स थिंग इज आल्सो राइट एट द सेम टाइम.
आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड के मैं आपको अभी मैं बोलता हूँ कि आप ना पूरी बुक भी पढ़ के आ जाइए आप मैं नेक्स्ट वीक पूरा एग्जाम ले लेता हूँ आपका सो हाउ वुड यू लाइक दैट सो इट्स लाइक स्ट्रेसिंग आउट फॉर मेनी पीपल जॉब डूइंग जॉब एट सर्टेन पेस इज शुड बी रिलैक्सिंग आई मीन रिलैक्सिंग इन द सेंस ऐसा नहीं है उसके लिए पिकनिक है वो बट देन एट द सेम टाइम इट शुड नॉट बी स्ट्रेनुअस बिकॉज द वर्कर मे नॉट बी एबल टू सस्टेन दैट पेस अच्छा होता क्या है एवरीवन जो न्यूरल नेटवर्क होता है बॉडी का एवरी ह्यूमन बीइंग हैज अ डिफरेंट न्यूरल नेटवर्क तो एबिलिटीज भी डिफरेंट होती हैं उसके हैंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन भी अलग होता है द कुछ हर जना तो स्पोर्ट्समैन नहीं बन जाता राइट सो सिमिलरली लाइक दैट द हैंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन द लिम कोऑर्डिनेशन इज नॉट सेम इन ऑल द पीपल सो दिस इज व्हाट वी टॉक अबाउट Okay. So, how do we obtain and record the information? There are many types of sheets. I'll just share the screen. We can just see some of them.
So, please explain this extend part of time study once again.
Which part?
Extend part, fourth part.
Okay. Now, we are going to talk about each one of them in detail.
Okay,
yeah. So on the screen you can see that there are some kind of sheets which are used. They are not definitive, but they give you a sample that how can you record the data. Like general purpose time study sheet is given over here, where you record the department, operation, machine on which they're working, who's studying. Who's the person who's studying it? Who's the operative? So what time you're starting it? Element description. What are the elements you have to record? And then rating and you can see R, W, R, S, T. Watch reading, subtracted time, and the basic time. So these are some of the elements you can say if you take a reading and then basic time. So basic time is another term. Which is coming into our mind over here. Anyone who can tell what will be the meaning of basic time?
Minimum irreducible time for a work.
Anyone else?
The time similar to standard time in work study, the time similar to that, excluding the idle time and ineffective time.
Okay. I would like to hear more. What do you think would be the basic time?
Some minimum time required to perform a job with minor delays.
Okay, so basic time we can say is I'll just write the formula. So there are a few terms which often are going to use here now and then. So let me tell you about few things. So performance rating. All these different kind of times and all, they fall under the umbrella of performance rating. Okay, so why am I doing the performance rating first of all? So the performance rating you can say is one of the objectives of doing time study. And it is a technique for equitably calculating the time required to perform a task by a normal operator after observing the actual values. Okay, so normal operator की performance rating जो बनाई जाती है उसके अंदर relative to बनाई जाती है एक average operator. ठीक है, normal operator जो हम already पढ़ चुके हैं कि normal operator को हम define कैसे करते हैं. So with performance rating, we gauge and compare the pace or rate of a worker against the setup performance level. So basic time is the basic time. So word basic time is observed time multiplied with performance level of worker. Divided by standard performance level expected. Okay, now the term standard performance. Observed time का तो मतलब है कि जो हमने हमारी stopwatch में देखा time जो हमको WR जो form में लिखा है watch reading है ना, so that is your you can say observed time, and standard performance is the rate of output. We can say here standard performance is the rate of output which qualified worker, or we can say normal operator, will naturally achieve without over exertion. So rate of output achieved by normal operator without
sir aapki screen abhi wo table show kar rahi hai sir.
Okay yes, so I think I forgot to share this screen, just a second. So standard performance is rate of output achieved by normal operator without overexertion. Overexertion. Okay. So we denote on the standard rating, we denote it as 100, and there is, I think this is clear now. Basic time, this is how we calculate the basic time. So this is the rate of output achieved by a normal operator, and this is the output which is actually giving multiplied with the observed time. So it is still time units only. You can say unit is not changing. So that's how we calculate the basic time. So we generally don't define it directly like you people have defined it, but in numeric terms we define it as the basic time. So we have to do this calculation when we are using that kind of sheet. Any doubt in this? So you can say that if you are taking more time, अगर आप ज्यादा टाइम ले रहे हैं एक एक पर्टिकुलर काम करने में, तो आपका जो रेशियो है परफॉर्मेंस लेवल ऑफ वर्कर डिवाइडेड बाय स्टैंडर्ड परफॉर्मेंस लेवल एक्सपेक्टेड, ये 1 से ज्यादा होगा या 1 से कम होगा? सो बेसिक टाइम एक अच्छे वर्कर के लिए या मोर देन एवरेज वर्कर के लिए जो बेसिक टाइम है वो ज्यादा आएगा या कम आएगा, आप ये बता सकते हैं? एक नॉर्मल ऑपरेटर से जो ऊपर है वर्कर,
लेस देन वन,
हाँ बेसिक टाइम कम आएगा ज्यादा आएगा उसका?
कम आएगा
सर। कम आएगा सर। लेवल कैसे जज करेंगे सर?
मान लीजिए आपको स्टैंडर्ड परफॉर्मेंस लेवल एक्सपेक्टेड है 100, ठीक है, और आप दे रहे हैं 102 परफॉर्मेंस लेवल ऑफ अ वर्कर, आउटपुट देख रहे हैं ना आप एक तरीके से, लेट्स से अगर वो 100 वर्क पीसेस बनाने हैं उसको 8 आवर शिफ्ट में, तो स्टैंडर्ड परफॉर्मेंस एक्सपेक्टेड तो 100 हो गई, और अगर वो ज्यादा अच्छा कर रहा है तो 102 आएगी, तो आपका जो बेसिक टाइम है वो ऑब्जर्व टाइम से ज्यादा आएगा फिर, है ना? सो दिस थिंग वी हैव टू टेक इनटू अकाउंट दैट बेसिक टाइम जनरली अच्छे वर्कर के लिए ज्यादा आता है.
So, ज्यादा समय नहीं है सर.
हाँ, क्योंकि परफॉर्मेंस लेवल ऑफ वर्कर जो है, ये रेशो, ये वाला जो रेशो है ये मोर देन 1 आएगा ना, तो आप मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे ऑब्जर्व टाइम आपका मान लीजिए 10 मिनट्स है, तो आपका बेसिक टाइम तो 1. समथिंग से मल्टीप्लाई होगा, तो आपका ऑब्जर्व टाइम उससे मल्टीप्लाई होने के बाद ज्यादा हो जाएगा ऑब्जर्व टाइम से, राइट? सो वी विल अंडरस्टैंड, ये आगे जाके और समझ में आएगा जब बेसिक टाइम का आपको पूरा फंडा समझ में आएगा. सो राइट नाउ इट्स लेट्स नॉट ट्राई टू इंटरप्रेट द बेसिक टाइम इन टर्म्स ऑफ यू कैन से अ फिजिकल एंटिटी. It's rather, it's a formula rather, for now it is a formula rather than any physical interpretation of basic time, because तरीके से तो time कम होना चाहिए ना. Basic time कोई worker है उसको काम करने में कम time लग रहा है तो basic time उसका कम आना चाहिए, but उसका ज्यादा आ रहा है. ठीक है, तो वो हम करेंगे इस बारे में बात. और
सर इसके एक बार definition क्या होगी सर language में,
उसकी बाद में बताऊंगा मैं definition. अभी भी आप फॉर्मूला देखेंगे जब इसके डेफिनेशन, अगर मैं अभी बताऊंगा बाद में आपको फिर इशू होगा अंडरस्टैंडिंग में. सो इसके डेफिनेशन हम बाद में देखेंगे, बट बेसिक टाइम का ये फॉर नाउ द सिग्निफिकेंस इज दिस. ओके, या देन देयर इज अनदर टर्म कॉल्ड रेटिंग फैक्टर. So rating factor, or also known as leveling factor. Is a factor by which the observed time is multiplied in order to adjust for differences in operator performances. So rating factor kya hai? Observed time se multiply hota hai. ऑब्जर्व टाइम से मल्टीप्लाई होता है रेटिंग फैक्टर, सो दैट आई कैन एडजस्ट फॉर डिफरेंसेस इन द ऑपरेटर परफॉर्मेंसेस. बिकॉज परफॉर्मेंस रेटिंग इज यूज्ड टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द परफॉर्मेंस टू और मोर ऑपरेटर्स. ओके, सो it can also show day to day variations in the level of performance of the same work.
इतना कम खा रहे
हैं. ठीक है, क्योंकि आपकी जो day to day performance है वो भी same. I think mute, please mute all of you. Same नहीं रहेगी. Daily performance तो आप लोगों की same नहीं रहती है, right? So that also varies. Similarly, operator to operator performance भी vary करती है. So when you are going to when you are going to note an observation of time of certain worker, आपने observe करा, फिर उसको एक rating factor से multiply करते हैं, so that वो थोड़ा adjust हो जाए. ये adjustment क्यों करना है हमको, इसके बारे में भी हम बात करेंगे जब एक numerical solve करेंगे. Okay, so I will limit this discussion to this point where we are talking about recording, because agar hum abhi aur zyada aage baat karenge to I mean the whole essence will be lost. So I come back to where we what we were discussing. I was showing you a form, a general template for doing time study. In that there was a term basic time, so I introduced the term basic time. Theek hai, after that there are several other forms which are also given in your book which are using the term basic time. So you can, whenever you are facing the term basic time, you can come back to this. But ye rating factor wala probably you can let it go for now. Isko hum at the end of the chapter wapas leke aayenge in the context. So we forget about rating factor right now, but we are still talking about the obtaining and recording. We are at this point because select and define, we have already thought about it. We have already talked about ki ek job ko select karna chahiye and uska definition bhi clear honi chahiye, uske elements clear karna hai. So I have told you that wo video watch karenge aap, welding wala jo video hai uske andar jo steps hain, jo usme जो जो एलिमेंट्स में ब्रेक किया जा सकता है जॉब को वो आप करेंगे. सो दैट इज लाइक डिफाइनिंग द जॉब. ओके, देन ओपनिंग एंड रिकॉर्डिंग. सो देर आर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फॉर्म्स विच आर देर विच कैन बी यूज्ड इफ इफ इट्स अ वेरी शॉर्ट साइकिल स्टडी और अ वेरी फास्ट जॉब विच हैपेंस इन लाइक 30 seconds और 1 minute. सो that for that also a short cycle study form is given in the book which can be used, which gives you a flexibility of standardizing some elements of the job. Okay, so basically what information we gather can be grouped in several headings, could like information which gives which enable the product or part being processed to be accurately identified, या information जो हमको चाहिए होती है, हम form से क्या क्या information निकाल सकते हैं, वे जो हमको process method plant और machine के बारे में accurately identify करने में help करती है. And then of course इस form में हम और भी लिखते हैं duration, time duration of the each element and कितना time जा रहा है उसको करने में. Okay, so we will continue. Yeah, I'm just opening the attendance sheet now. Start giving the attendance. I will keep it open till 10:55. Give your attendance. I'm concluding the lecture for today. And we'll continue from where I'm left.